Welcome to my channel. Today we're going to be doing my January bullet journal spreads for 2022 in my Ultra and Olive and Plant-Based Bride collaboration. I uploaded my beginning spreads and today we're focusing on January. I'm using my 2021 September spread as inspiration and I'm just doing a very basic January monthly glance. We're just filling in some of the dates. This takes forever and I can't get it centered, so we're gonna have this like weird angle going on. The flowers were an aesthetic choice and now I kind of regret it because it took the focus away sometimes, but they move on and off during the video. So yeah. We're doing my collage header style, just placing down some paper under so that when I put my black washi tape over the top, it doesn't look like it kind of elevates the picture a bit more. It doesn't look as blended in. I'm just filling in with my white gel pen the days of the week. Got, you know, I have to do backwards because my left-handedness smudges the crap out of anything that I write in gel pen. We're skipping forward, pulling out this is my like go-to paper that I use all the time, and I'm just yanking out some vintage map paper that I used previously in my Marvel Comics spread. I love the way this turns out. I just like that paper in particular. It's beautiful. But continuing to use that like flowery floral print, but with the top there's like kind of a grid imagery, so I thought that'd be nice for a good header. I am slowly writing out January. This took me like several takes, so don't believe that I'm the best writer. In first hit, this was just me being lucky. I do cut it out, and look, it's pretty. It took me forever to write it, but yeah. We're doing a little bit of a close-up shot so that it's more in focus. We're just like grabbing some lined paper, you know, moving it around, basic scrapbooking stuff, and bringing out my go-to floral stickers. Floral? Leafy? Plantly? You know what I'm saying. We're decorating more with that, the rest of that lined paper, and we're just adding another January up top. I haven't really decided what color scheme we're going for this month. I'm thinking maybe like a light purple could be the look. We don't know. We'll see. This next spread, yet again, we're playing around with this floral pattern. I really like the top grid part, so I'm utilizing that again. I hate that there's like a little circle there, but I just didn't want to mess around with it, so I left it. We're doing a finances money spread where I'm just writing down, like separating how much I used and how much I'm budgeting. Each week has about 5, maybe 6 different categories. Stuff like rent, stuff like groceries, entertainment, food out, that sort of thing. I do have a little other section in case I have any big spending. Up the top part, I'm going to be writing my basic bills that I always have. Just, you know, trying to keep a track of how much money I spend and when I spend it. I haven't really labeled them, but you get the gist. Bringing out some more stickers, and we're just using the paper to make a books and TV spread. I smudged the crap out of the K and the S, as well as the M, on this money title. Just because, like, left-handedness, so I had to go over the K and the S again, and I kind of ruined the lettering that I did, but it's fine. We managed. Alright, for my weekly spreads, I should have really filled this out then, but I find it easier to do so when I'm actually using them, because each day, whether or not I use the bullet journal or not, it changes the size of the book, like, of the passages that I use. I'm just trying out a rolling weekly sort of just like jotting down my ideas and things and then using the other separate pages on either side of that flap to properly break down the days in what morning, afternoon, and night. But that's basically basically all that I did for my January spread. This video is really, really quick. I just wanted to show you guys some of my basic things that I put together for during the month. I don't really do any trackers or anything, but thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again next week. Have a lovely day. I plan on making more of these videos later on. Thank you for watching.